When was the last time you made a new friend? In our culture of too much work and too much living in our digital world, it's not always easy to forge a lasting friendship that truly makes a difference in our lives. Yet that is exactly the type of story KellaLand's Brady Mallory is bringing us in tonight's I Am KellaLand at 10. He's joining us on the couch today to tell us how it all came together into a story you have to see to believe.
Hey, yeah.
Welcome, Brady.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Just looking at the background information for this, I started getting goosebumps.
Yeah.
Give us a little insight to what you found.
Isn't it crazy to think that the person we meet on the street or they walk by us, they could play a big role in our lives someday, and that's what this story is about. These two women, Kara Hoynes and Katie Erdahl, worked together at a Sioux Falls restaurant. Kara had just started, Katie had been there for a while. And Kara had said that she had a hard time getting to know people at first because everyone there was established and had friendships. She and Katie ended up becoming friends slowly but surely, and then years later, that friendship would be very important to saving a life.
Okay, so how did you decide to do this story?
I'm a big believer in connection. Like, I just love thinking about how we're all connected. Something like things that have happened to me maybe 7 or 8 years ago come full circle, and I'm like, wow, that was like the point of getting to know this person or getting to meet this person. So that's what caught my attention. And then, so one of the reasons why this friendship is important is Katie's brother found out that he had kidney disease and he needed a kidney transplant. And so that's a big key factor in the story that I told. So those couple of things together, friendship and the chance to maybe help someone really spoke to me.
Why do you think it is so hard in this generation, in this day and age, to make new friends?
Well, here, I can use this as a prop. I think this is basically us wherever we go, right?
Right.
We're just on our phones. So I see that a lot. I think it's hard to make friends because we are just really distracted by a lot of things, and we are always so connected to our devices. The connection with other people sometimes goes missing because we don't need to do that anymore.
Right.
So I think it's tough to make friends just because a lot of us don't go outside of our own little bubble and make that effort.
So when talking to these two individuals, what did you really take away from their friendship? Was it fast growing? What did they kind of say about each other and how did they interact?
You know, it was funny when you meet people who are really good friends and you interview them, do you ever notice they kind of answer the questions in the
yeah.
same way?
Yep.
So I asked them both, what do you like about each other? And they both said, oh, so-and-so is very kind. So-and-so is the nicest person I know. And they just spoke so highly about each other. So that's kind of how I knew that they were really close. And have you ever made a friend at work or made a friend with someone that you didn't expect it, but then you think about, wow, we are really connected?
Yeah, and moving here and not knowing one person,
yeah.
I kind of went through that whole thing too. And like you mentioned how she didn't really know anyone and anyone was really established.
Mm-hmm.
That is so true.
Oh, yeah.
When you come in here and everyone has their friend groups, they grew up here, they've been friends for forever, it's hard to kind of wiggle your way into
mm-hmm.
a group of friends that have been established for a long
yeah.
time.
Yeah, yeah, and then once you get in there, you know, do you ever think like, oh, I hope that I pay this forward and I treat a stranger with the same kindness and help them become friends? And here's a look at my story. So that is Kara, and then that is Eric Knutson. He is the brother of Katie, who needed a kidney, and there they are just kind of hanging out. We have a photo of Katie and Kara doing friend things. So again, like, just being friends, it started out really normally, and then you never know when a big opportunity to help someone will come along.
Right.
So we're teasing this story a lot. I promise tonight at 10, all of these mysteries and these little plot points will come together.
Yeah. And having good friends when you are going through a rough time,
mm-hmm.
what did you learn when interviewing them about that?
You know, even if one of your friends is going through a rough time, if you can't do a lot to help them, I think just being there for the person and letting them know that you care. Nobody really has anything to offer except kind words. And sometimes that makes a difference for people who are going through a tough time. So that also struck me about this story, is just how powerful it can be to be nice to someone at all times. It's not always easy, but
right.
we should strive to.
And so part of this story, we don't want to give too much away, but part of this is about having the kidney disease and,
mm-hmm.
you know, needing a kidney. So when we talk about donors, organ donors,
mm-hmm.
what did you find about that?
Well, I believe it was from the Mayo Clinic, about 93,000 people in America are waiting for a kidney. And finding a match is so tremendously difficult. And normally a lot of kidneys will come from a deceased donor. And that can take, you know, finding a match for someone, that can take 5+ years. So that's, you know, hours and hours and years of time. Someone's on dialysis waiting, and that's really, that's can be tough on your body. It's not ideal. So, you know, I just learned that I think a lot of people think, if I'm not a donor, it doesn't matter because all of these people are donors. It really does matter because, you know, there are thousands and thousands and thousands of people waiting for a second shot at life, and it really has to be a very precise match. So the more people who can be a donor, the better. And it's really easy. I just, you know, checked the donor box when I got my driver's license.
Yeah.
You just check the box and you don't really have to think about it.
Well, actually, that's exactly what I did. I was filling out my form, mm-hmm. and I had the box to check, and I just kind of thought, okay, well, why not? But I didn't really know a lot about it or mm-hmm. what it really meant. So why do you think some people are skeptical about being donors?
I think we are very attached, obviously, to ourselves. And I think the idea of thinking about maybe having your organs harvested, that's a lot for people to think about. Of course it is. But you know, you can't take them with you when you're going. And I've interviewed a lot of people who have talked about getting a transplant, getting another shot at life. So it is a really powerful decision. And of course, everyone needs to make that decision for themselves. But you know, you are helping someone just by checking the box. So it is a lot to think about, but there are people and professionals in place who will make sure your choice gets put to good use.
Okay. Yeah. Well, thank you so much, Brady, for coming on and telling us more about this.
Hey, thanks for having me, everyone.
Brady, along with photojournalist Tom Murrow, take you deeper inside this unique friendship and show you the surprising twist in the friendship that proved to be life-changing for everyone involved. That's tonight's Eye on Keloland during the 10 o'clock news.